Okay. Our previous studies, we learned about the structure element of the international system and the state as a subject of international law, whereby we learned about how states behave within the international system. Whereby states within the international system are governed by international law, and within a particular state, they are being controlled by their national laws. And within the international system, we learned that according to the realist theory, they see the international system to be in the form of anarchy. So for a state to behave within the anarchy form of international system, you consider the state power. Okay? That is what we learned for our previous studies. Today we are going to tackle interesting aspect of the international system that in recent system we need to consider and take notice of it very well. Okay, so today we are coming to start a topic called the balance of power system. Okay, the balance of power system. With the anarchy form of international system at the back of our mind, which was proposed by the theorists. Though we have a lot of theories that have been proposed, like the liberal system, the radical system, the constructivism, the Marxism, and others. But with all these theories, they all believe that we have an international anarchy system. So all the assumptions based on which these theories are based, they all see the basis that the international system is in the form of anarchy. Okay? So, John Maxwell, who is one of the international relations scholars, proposed three ways in which the international system, he considering the anarchy form of the system, he proposed three ways on how he viewed the international system to be. So with John Maxwell, he talked about how porous the international system is. So he considers something like polarity. Call something like polarity. Okay? Polarity. The polarity is the number of states that exert power within the international system. So, according to John Maxwell, with this polarity, he considers that within the anarchy form of the international system, okay, we have one to be unipolar. Okay, so according to John Maxwell, within the anarchy form of the international system, his view is based on three assumptions: the unipolar system, the bipolar system, and the multipolar system. So I'm going to be more practical so that we understand how this polarity of John Maxwell is being implemented within the anarchy form of international system. Okay? So for instance, we have five states, okay, exerting power, big powers within the international system. For instance,
Okay, we have, let's say, this is one state, two, three, four, and then five within the international system. We have these five states within the international system. Okay? And then Masma is saying that when you consider the unipolar system, he's saying that it means within this five, within the international system, the five states, they are all having powers within the international system. But when you talk about the unipolar, it means that within these five states, one state is having powers which is beyond the other four states. So you talk about unipolar system. So for instance, this state, okay, bigger than all the four states within the international system, then you see that it is unipolar. So we call something like hegemonic. Hegemonic. Okay? Hegemonic is when one state within the international system, okay, considering these five states, and look at the base circle, assuming its power. So it means this state is having big powers as compared to the other four. Okay? In this example, you can see that this state is having the hegemonic powers within the five states in the international system. So when you consider the unipolar system, it means that one state has certain powers, big powers, as compared to other states within the international system. You also talk about bipolar. The bipolar system talks about two states. When you consider historically, okay, before the Cold War, Great Britain was having a hegemonic powers. They were the only state which was powerful. But after the Cold War, the Second World War, we had the United States also becoming big power within the international system. So for instance, if you are considering Great Britain and the United States, who is having big powers within the international system, then we can see that we are experiencing a bipolar system. A bipolar system. When two states within the international system is controlling other states within the international system. Okay? But when we talk about the multipolar system, which we'll be emphasizing much more, then we'll be considering the bipolar, the multipolar system, okay? The multipolar system, which we'll be doing much on it today, okay? It's whereby we have a number more influential states exerting big powers within the international system, okay? Then we say that we are in the multipolar international system, okay? And the multipolar international system is what we call the balance of power, okay? So I want to elaborate small about how balance of power is created within the international system. For instance, okay, these states, these five states in the international system, how are they going to create balance of power within the international system? We have two ways whereby a state will be able to balance the power of big powers within the international system. Now, we have five states, okay? And within the five states, let's say one is bigger than the others. Okay, one is having the upper hand, hegemon, over the four states. Okay, so we want to know how the balance of power system is created. One, okay, this four states will be able to balance the power of this state by one, increasing their own power. Okay, the first point, for other four states to balance the power of this hegemonic state within the international system, one thing we can do is to